Côte d'Ivoire est on the way of recovering from 10 years of violent crisis. But it is just a process because the crisis was very deep. It was more political, human, economic and social. So it will take time for Côte d'Ivoire to totally recover, but I think that the grounds have been built and the basis is there for recovering. The reconciliation process is linked to the key issue of justice and more precise the issue of impartiality and the equity of justice and also to the problem of fully participative democratic process. All the other, these problems are still not totally resolved. That the traditional and religious judicial agenda is so heavy that they have to try all those who have been released recently, but provisionally released, the former hierarchy of the former government. There are many of them. Mrs. Gbagbo has to be tried because Côte d'Ivoire has decided that they will assume their primary responsibility of judging her in Côte d'Ivoire, not yielding her to the International Criminal Court and others. So the judicial agenda is very heavy. Second problem, for the election to be credible, the independent electoral commission has to be reformed. Everybody agrees that it has to be reformed because it does not reflect the reality of the political landscape of Côte d'Ivoire. Of reconciliation and the democratic construction, the whole... Le troisième problème maintenant de fond est le problème économique et social. Ce qui relève de mon mandat, c'est-à-dire les droits économiques et sociaux et culturels. C'est-à-dire que la Côte d'Ivoire, d'un côté, a réussi d'une manière extrêmement positive, il faut le dire, à atteindre un taux de croissance de 8 à 9%. Et c'est quelque chose de qu'on n'a pas vu dans d'autres pays africains qui ont connu des crises similaires. Mais cette croissance macroéconomique ne s'est pas encore traduite dans le panier de la ménagère. C'est-à-dire que tant que l'Ivoirien moyen ne pourra pas amener son enfant à l'école, trouver un emploi, un logement, se soigner ou soigner sa famille, la situation économique et sociale risque d'éroder tout le processus de réconciliation et de dialogue.